This is a very specific question, but I will try and answer it a bit broadly to include all potential options. The first thing, someone undergoes an ablation and that ablation is successful, it's possible that although acutely it looked successful, because when you ablate you does cause significant edema around the accessory pathway that may not be able to conduct, and therefore the delta wave may disappear from the 12-lead ECG, but later on when you repeat the 12-lead ECG 3 months down the line after the ablation, when the inflammation has settled, you're still able to witness that delta wave, just because the extra pathway is still there. The second option is that you may potentially have multiple pathways, in that you ablate one of the pathways but you still have one or two extra ones that can conduct on top of your atrioventricular node, which is the usual form of conduction within our heart. I will however expect that adenosine, or that blocks the AV node and tries to see whether there is conduction within the other pathways, may have highlighted those extra pathways. Occasionally, I suppose if those pathways are extremely slow, they may not show up even during adenosine testing. And the third potential option may be in people who have an underlying heart muscle condition. For example, we commonly see what we call pseudo-delta waves. So we see a deflection at the beginning of the QRS complex of the ECG on an individual who has hypertrophic cardiomyopathy. And when we try and do the electrophysiological study, we can't actually find an accessory pathway within that individual. So broadly, these are the three options I can think of that may give you a persistent delta wave, despite the fact that you've been reassured that you had an electrophysiological study or even a successful ablation procedure that eliminated or did not identify an accessory pathway.